I've never found an applicable way.
Rachel doesn't seem so troubled based on all this.
Hello, hello.
There's not much here about the police investigation.
Wow, she was a year older than everybody else. July 22nd, 1994, Rachel Dawn Amber, 67-something brief summary, GPA 4.0, so she was a genius as well, if I'm not mistaken. Rachel Amber is the quintessential student representation of Blackwell Academy. She excels in all of her studies and extracurricular activities, which are numerous. Popular with both students and faculty, she has the de facto qualities of scholarship and leadership that is the hallmark of Blackwell's legacy. Her diverse goals include a career in international law and fashion modeling. There is no doubt that Rachel will achieve all of her dreams with Blackwell as a fulcrum. Principal Wells, this is Lieutenant Colonel Rossi. Just wanted to let you know that Rachel Amber's investigation has officially been closed on our end. We always hope for the one magic clue, but once again Arcadia Bay covers up another secret. We always keep our eyes and ears open, but that's all we can do from now. Thanks for all your help, Lieutenant Chris Rossi, Arcadia Bay Police Department. Update. Unfortunately, Rachel Amber has stopped attending class for the past month. You gotta put fucking dates on this shit. As of this specific date, she has not attended class, and she's left no contact with students or faculty for the past month. Her parents are at the present unaware of her whereabouts, and Blackwell hopes for her quick return to continue her academic excellence.
Man, I don't blame the principal for expelling Chloe.
Ah, Blackwell Academy. Student information, Chloe Elizabeth Price. Price? Yeah. Expelled for being a shitbag. GPA 1.7. Didn't even try, girl. They had to fucking jam expelled on there twice. You almost broke the stamp when you hit it that hard, didn't you? Mr. Jefferson, who the hell is the principal? Whatever. Chloe Price is a problematic student at Blackwell, despite the best efforts of the faculty and administration to guide her academically. Chloe does little homework and is often willfully belligerent to her teachers. She has caused numerous class disruptions with inappropriate comments and rude gestures to fellow students. She was recently suspended for spray painting graffiti in the parking lot. Even though Chloe is an intelligent student with potential, she chooses to squander it on empty rebellion against a non-mandatory institution. Update. Chloe Price is no longer a student at Blackwell. See attached police reports. Where are these police reports? Where are these documents, Chloe?
I think we found everything in here. I should go join Chloe now.
Have I? Because there's some files
so,
over here.
Prescott's dad is a bully, too. Shocker.
Principal Raymond Wells. Sean Prescott here. Principal Wells, in light of the recent outrageous allegations against my son and his suspension, I feel that my large contributions to Blackwell Academy should also be suspended. Of course, this situation can be rectified once Nathan is reinstated at Blackwell with a written apology. Along with that, I understand the tragic events, including Miss Marsh, give you pause. But I would suggest that canceling Thursday's party is non-conductive to the can-do spirit of the Blackwell Academy. I expect you to reconsider and come to the same obvious conclusion. Thank you, Sean Prescott. Mr. Sean Prescott. Big Dick G.
That is so cool that my signature actually counted. Go, Miss Grant.
Dear Miss Grant, as principal of Blackwell Academy, it is my glad, happy, fortunate duty, to inform you that your petition to block the installation of a new surveillance system has received enough signatures for the school to reject the plan. It is not my policy to take sides in these matters, as we encourage the faculty and student body to participate in the school's operations. However, I did recognize the controversial nature of these cameras and share your concern for the possible invasion of privacy. Thank you for your passion and for inspiring Blackwell students to make their voices heard. I hope they will feel empowered by the outcome of your petition. Best wishes. Or just best. Why not? Principal Wells. But the Mel's scribble. Maybe you tried to spell Wells, but had a stroke halfway through. Can't tell.
You're not so tacky up close.
Yeah, you're not so bad that I want to take a picture of you. I want a picture of you. Son of a bitch. God damn you. How dare you defy me? What the hell is...
I'd drink too if I was the principal.
Nice. Very nice. Okay. Can you get a shot of that bronze? Chloe, can you get the fuck out of the way so I can... whatever, fine. Okay, I feel that I have certainly looked at everything applicable and available in here.
Bringing drugs on campus?
Does he?
And my step troll went along because he thinks Rachel was a bad influence on me. Assholes. If David is teaming up with Nathan Prescott, that's a bad sign. Nathan Prescott III. Ooh, he's so money. Oh. And you know the Prescotts dropped major bank to bury Nathan's real file. Look, it reads like
expunged.
A rap sheet. Bad grades, teacher complaints, secret probation. But I was expelled? At least Nathan was finally suspended. Check out that note.
And he had a decent GPA, where you just didn't give a fuck.
It's just some crazy drawing.
Is it now?
It's not a drawing. Look. Rachel in the dark room. Rachel in the dark room.
That's not a drawing, that's just words scribbled on there.
Fucked up.
All work and no play make Johnny a dull boy.
He's truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing. Whoa, listen to this. David M. always asks what's going on in my head. David M. always helps me follow those he follows. It's pretty cryptic.
No, it sounds like they formed some sort of weird team, the Super Hebros.
Jesus. David was stalking Kate.
Well, he was harassing her.
And now we know he was all over Rachel, too.
Oh, we are so going into his garage files. Plus, I'm getting a little paranoid in here.
Yeah.
We gotta leave, let's bail. But maybe we shouldn't leave without a gift.
You gonna take a shit on his desk?
Not taking the cozy chair.
Max, do your powers include mind reading?
No.
Or did you just rewind because I tried to steal the chair? Shit, I'm confused.
You're unnaturally predictable.
I know how you roll. We should definitely get out of here. We pressed our luck enough.
Hello, what have we here?
School money.
Holy shit! Jackpot! Cha-ching!
Wowzer. That's a lot for the handicapped fund.
Dude, there's $5,000 here. I could pay Frank back tonight.
The handicapped fund.
This will chill him out after you almost, you know, shot him.
He wanted to stab you, bitch.
Are you going to make a big issue out of this?
It's the handicap
fund. Or just
rewind
and take the greenbacks for yourself. I hope you do that instead of lecturing me.
No. Leave the money. Are you fucking with me?
You really want to take money from the handicapped fund?
Think about this action.
I know you need to pay Frank back, but... I've got my power to protect you, right?
There's a lot of power in that horse-choking wad of cash.
Yeah.
But yes.
For the handicap fund?
I guess. Let's get the hell out of this office, morgue.
You want to fucking steal? For the... Okay, sure. It's great.
I know that money would have helped Chloe and me.
You have no moral scruples. You are... That is fucking... Oh my god. No. I want you, Hawk.
That is so
no,
cool.
Not
my
you.
Signature actually... Just, you're not so tacky up close.
No, it's not so tacky up close. I want a fucking picture of the fucking... Oh, the computer. I didn't get a chance to interact with that. Disciplinary warning report. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Prescott, we regret to inform you that Nathan Prescott has disturbed various classes over the past month despite repeated warnings and leniency. Due to a crude outburst in Mrs. Hodia's intro to literature class on Tuesday, September 17th, thank you! You didn't just write fucking today. You actually gave a goddamn date, like people should do in a file. Nathan was sent back to his dormitory for the day. Without a proper write-up for his files, Nathan has enormous potential but is also erratic. Behavior patterns that may need supervision beyond Blackwell's ability. The school cannot tolerate these disruptions, so we hope you will discuss this matter with Nathan to impress upon him the severity of this situation. Please see the attached file for full report. Update, expunged record. We just fucking wiped this away because your money made it disappear. Amazing how money has a way of doing that. Dear Principal Wells, we received a rather outrageous and possibly slanderous letter from somebody in administration accusing Nathan of uncharacteristic erratic behavior patterns. We're certain this must be a mistake. Otherwise, we fear that we will take Nathan out of Blackwell to a more prestigious and better funded institution. Please respond with a copy of the expunged disciplinary warning report. Fuck you. And look at that bullshit dickhead Prescott seal. Blackwell Incident Report, Nathan Prescott. The following is a list of reported incidents involving Nathan Prescott. There seems to be a pattern of outbursts and confrontations followed by remorse and repentance. We suggest his parents remove him from the school and place him under expert psychological supervision. Throwing a desk in class. That's not bad. Cursing at his English teacher. I've heard worse. Lighting firecrackers in the bathroom. Boys will be boys. Stealing school supplies. You're rich. There's no justification for that whatsoever. Threatening the school custodian. He is very fucking weird, that school custodian. Attempted theft of campus Tobanga statue. He could have just bought it. He could have bought a better one. That doesn't make any sense at all. Rachel in the dark room. Yeah, that's pretty fucked up too. David Masson and Nathan Prescott have both come to my office to warn me that Rachel Amber has been a drug mule, in Mr. Madsen's talk radio terminology, acting as a front for another local dealer. Considering Rachel's exemplary status, I told David that I would need more concrete proof, and he promised he had more to show. I was surprised to get an unscheduled visit from Rachel Amber. She was quite upset and claimed that David Madsen was following her and taking photographs. David would deny this, and given the questionable company Rachel has been keeping, I'm not certain I can believe her right now. Wow, Chloe, way to fuck it up for Rachel. You ass. That fucking bird. That bird. It's in here. It's right there. Why can I not? Or maybe that's not the same bird, because it doesn't have three little things hanging off of it. Whatever, fine. I've gotten two photos out of this area. I'm content.
That impish look scares me.
What are you planning?
Care for a midnight swim? The Blackwell pool is ours.
Swimming? Interesting.
You want to take that risk now?
It's midnight.
It's been a cray week. You didn't let me take that money to pay off Frank, so if he pops a cap in my skull, at least allow me to have a little carefree fun for a few minutes.
I think you'll pop one in your ass first.
Splish splash? You're right. We hella deserve it.
Stop using hella.
Splish splash. Did you actually just say hella? I think I'm a good bad influence on you.
Oh, yes. It got to that point where everyone was just shitting all of the developers of their millennial talk. And they actually made a reference towards how hella is... I don't even think that they used that terminology whatsoever in episode 2, did they? And I guess they threw it out here just as a big old fuck you. And hey, we acknowledge fuck you.
We're in the otter's lair. Big fucking deal. I want that heated water.
A heated
pool. We still have to play it cool, okay? I still go to school here. You can own this hellhole once you figure out your rewind power.
Don't
Chloe
turn me
so
in.
Psyched for girls' night out, so I better follow her evil plan.
Evil, malicious plan.
I would love a soda, but I just get wired.
Really? That inclusion of sugar into your body will just... Well, I suppose you're like 58 pounds soaking wet. There is no justification for that. So you want to go swimming, hey? Women's locker room... Ads.
If only I could solve the mystery of the missing cat pics.
Reward. Desperate for my stolen backpack with school books and new tablet. I need this for class, and my tablet is private pics of my late cat. Rip. So I'll pay cash reward, no questions asked. If you have any details that would would like to return the backpack, you have my contact info. Please scribble at something other. Your backpack is in the lost and found in the fucking principal's office.
I hope the otters will survive.
The earth can't wait. Inform yourself, then share. Become an eco volunteer today. For further information, go to www.icecap.uo. Yeah, it's not that bad. Or maybe it is. I don't know.
I actually don't have the time to investigate this caper.
I lost my goggles. I admit I'm a goofball and misplaced my FlexiWear swim goggles. If found, eternal gratitude and $25. Bean Hip Cafe gift card, contact, $25 Bean Hip Cafe, contact Ray. Rhea Blackwell. Wow, you have your own individual email address and everything, too. All right, Chloe, what is your plan? Well, we are girls. But it would be more exciting to go through the boys!
Figures. Perv.
Ha!
Let me check to see if the pool's heated.
Yeah, hentai. Go through the boys. Yes! Yes, unexpected.
Oh, wait. I guess somebody forgot their Blackwell spirit.
Can I roll that back and go through the girls' locker room and check out all of, like...
I guess I should consider this evolution.
Dana, I know I'm a a-hole, but I still care about you. Love, Logan. Fuck off, Logan, you scumbag piece of shit. No worries.
Sometimes.
It's all bad. Shit. Anything else? Pick up the pace a tiny bit here. Zachary's jersey.
No way am I touching Zach's jersey.
Come on now. Someone left their fucking cell phone?
Zach is really careless. Doesn't he know what happens when I'm around?
Yeah. You go snooping. Victoria Chase. Okay. Hey, thinking bad things about you. Cool. What are you wearing? Just my crystal necklace and a phone. Hot. What are you wearing? I'm in the locker room, only wearing a jersey, sitting on my football. Hotter.
Zach is really careless. Doesn't he know what happens when I'm around?
Warren's locker. What you got
Daddy
in here?
He developed that in Jefferson's class. But why?
Because it's his fat material in the locker room. That's why.
Some poor hipster lost their vape.
Hey, actually recognizing e-cigarettes is vaping,
it's okay
bro.
For Nathan to be hooked on these drugs, right?
Diazepam, I think that is an antidepressant. Risperidone. Don't know what the fuck that one is. Diazepam. Wait, no, diazepam is to calm down somebody shaking. I think I only know that from Metal Gear Solid. It's a drug that you take when you get into sniper battles with Sniper Wolf to prevent you from shaking too much. Huh. Six me up? Pretty good.
Boys' locker room is right.
That's not where I'd write my messages in the boys' locker room. What the hell?
Huh, it's nice to know Victoria loves something besides herself.
That is a hairy D. It's a good big one, though. Wow.
Welcome to 1950.
Feminazi. You actually had to have two separate colored markers for that.
I bet you do.
I love Warren Graham. Hmm. Interesting and disturbing all at the same time. Why in the boys' room? Soap dispenser.
This one is almost empty. The guys must like their pink goo. Max Caulfield, moral avenger. Or self-righteous hypocrite.
It's a very gray line. Hard to tell at times. Dana needs a baby daddy. Dana is a hot, sweet, sexy cheerleader. Wait, there's no fucking 69 reasons to bang Rose
will be bros.
There's no urinal in here. Oh wait, never mind. There's several. I just wasn't fucking paying attention at all. Can I just ignore the direction that Chloe went and go into the girls' locker room to investigate as well? I'm very curious. Depends on how far I can rewind back, I guess. Because if so, I'm going to rewind to the point where I... You know, I'm just going to run that back. Run that back the whole way. Go through the girls' locker room now. Just for more flavor text. I imagine I'm going to have fucking pretty bad... Wait, that's not good. I'm in a place where I probably should not be. Shit, I fucked that up. I'm going to have to rewind when I get back into the foyer. Hey, girl. What the fuck are you doing in the men's room?
Presto. Dude, it's getting old. Try and dazzle me with another trick.
I'm not trying to dazzle you. I wanted to take an alternative path. How the fuck did you get in the boys' room? Now, I'll just run that back so you ain't talking shit. And then...
Boys or girls?
We're gonna go through the girls' locker room
girls,
now.
Girls, of course. Girls. Ooh la la.
Oh, don't
Let
you.
Let me check to see if the pool's heated.
Always helpful as ever, Chloe. Okay. What do we have hidden in the girls' locker room? It's just blood and tampons everywhere, isn't it?
Where does that other sock go?
Women are disgusting. They say that men are disgusting, but women are just...
Brooke wants to go to the drive-in with Warren.
The All-American Drive-In Theater. Oh yeah, Brooke is totally hard over fucking Warren. And Warren has just a throbbing hard for me. T-shirts.
Those are some musty-ass old shirts. Yuck.
They should almost have like a little washing machine and dryer in the women's locker room.
Comfy towels and towel history.
Does that make too much sense, or are children just too shitty to be able to have that foresight to be like, hey, my clothing is going to be fucking disgusting. Maybe I'll wash it in here with the school provided facility.
Bus ticket?
Oh.
Was she going to run away? Like Rachel Amber?
Arcadia Bay bus lines, one pure later trip ticket. October 2nd, 2013, $18, expires on the 1st. Is that Kate's locker? You didn't give much pre-emphasis on that. Or maybe it did, and I wasn't paying attention.
So, Victoria's secret is selfies. No. Jefferson said, don't confuse art with the artist. These are cool shots.
How grown up of you, Max. Okay, I need to... Yeah, that is Kate's locker. So, other than running away from all of our otters eat beavers. Really? In the girls' locker room?
It burns.
A lot of lockers for not that many students. Is it just me? Or it probably is just me. Does that seem a little out of place? Disproportioned. Rachel abides.
I hope so, friend.
I think that was meant in a sarcastic tone. It's really hard to tell. Dear Kate, I don't care. Oh.
Well, we care, dickhead.
Can we scrape this off the wall? Somehow? Come on now. That should be something that should be expunged from the world.
Sorry, Rachel.
Missing. Wow, Chloe, you were...
Ooh, pink goo. I see why everybody brings their own soap.
Pink goo is fine.
Oh, gorgeous. You wish, Max. You just look like a snoop.
Yeah, because we can't keep our nose out of everything.
For attention or anything.
And the woman shower. American schools. Give you some credit with that. Hey there, Chloe. I'm going to, yes, run. And I run so far away. Can't step over the pool. Oh, God. I could have fucking swore that was going to be an invisible wall. That was going to be a barrier where it's like, you can't step over the pool, Noodle. You can't do that. You're fucking completely incapable of doing anything that requires you to lift your foot more than half an inch above the ground. Hello.
Looks like I'm the Vortex Club bouncer. Decisions.
Remove names, you say.
Your names are not on the list.
What names?
You'll have to eat shit now.
Yeah, sure. Oh, my actions will have repercussions. How will they know? Who will know? Why would you leave the guest list for the Vortex Club just laying around at the pool? That makes no sense. There's no justification for that action. Are you fucking kidding me? Okay, no running, no diving. Well, I'm doing a lot of running, and I'll probably do some diving. Okay, so I could have made it into the boys' locker room through the back way instead of having to rewind time and manipulate it that way, but I didn't know. How the fuck was I going to know?
In case I run out of air, I know where to come.
Another drawer. What do we got here? Files of how poor people are,
yes,
at swimming?
We get it. Otters.
The Blackwell Academy 2012 swim team Otter Power. A lot of dudes' nipples. That's all I'm really seeing in this water. And that one girl looks like a fucking burn. Did you see that? The girl on the very far right of the photo looks like she is a burn victim.
Otters.
She lost a majority of the hair off her scalp, and unless she fucking went for the whole Skrillex thing, but that does not represent in this very minimalistic photo. Jesus Christ. I thought it said resuscitation dummy, but it's his rescue dummies. What's the hole in the... That is a hell of a belly button. I will switch that on. Actually, I think I know where that's going. Where it's like, we can't swim in here. It's too goddamn dark. Yes, of course we can't.
Aw, look at the baby Halloween pumpkin.
A pump-up-a-kin. As I've known them. Don't know where I got a cup of fucking...
Coffee and swimming. Good combo.
Yeah. You're going to tweak out from a can of pop, but you're perfectly fine looking at coffee.
Splish splash in the pool.
Max, try to find the light for the pool. I want to see the sharks.
There are no sharks. They don't swim with otters.
So do I. Hit that light.
DJ, turn it up. Yes, yes.
There has to be a control panel for the lights around here.
But where? Where can we find the control panel for the lights? Oh, Max, calm down. Fuck, those are some industrial lights. It's like an AC unit. Oh, wait, no. Wow, you changed very quickly there, Chloe. Holy Christ. Were you planning this? Like, you got some... Oh, okay.
Time to do or dive, Max.
So you weren't anticipating any special endeavors because you don't have matching underwear. Hell of a tattoo on your right arm, though. Hey, Chloe, at what point can I interact and have a chat at you?
Oh, yeah, baby. It feels like a hot tub. Too bad you made me feel like the queen of assholes because I wanted that cash stash.
Yeah, stealing from the handicap makes you like a dickhead. Hey!
Don't you dare!
I have my cell phone, fucker.
Okay, you asked for it.
I'm gonna fucking drop kick you in the throat. Well, only a dude would really do that.
Cowabunga.
Pink and white. Not matching either. Alright then.
Why, look, an otter in my water. Dun 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 dun. You are so obvious.
Man, I love Sharknado.
I still get freaked out by that movie, so stop. I can't even watch any of those shark shows.
Freaked out by Jaws? Come on! The only thing that should freak you out about Jaws is the story of the Indianapolis. That is fucking harrowing. And the delivery of that.
Otter's revenge. Cheater. Yeah, you wouldn't know about that.
You're talking shit about cheating now, Max. I think the water requires a little bit more of a reflective pattern on it.
She would totally love being in here at night.
Does have that diffraction.
You guys have met each other.
We will. With all this stuff going on, I'm starting to think everything is related, and I want to find out for Kate's sake. She almost died today.
Your power is changing everything, Max. Especially you. I can already tell. You're not so chicken shit anymore.
I have to admit,
thanks, girlfriend.
Jealous of these dainty women.
You're becoming like this force of nature.
I am a very top-heavy man, so therefore I just sink when it comes to water. I don't float.
Maybe I'm just stumbling back and forth in time. For what reason?
You didn't stumble when you saved me, Max.
Which time? What if I did? What if I did
Thank
fuck
God.
It up?
But what if I had? What if Kate didn't jump, but you would be dead?
So it's time to start moving forward in time. And we're obviously connected, since without me, you would have discovered your power, right?
That's... Sure!
Absolutely. You make me feel like I know what I'm doing.
No.
You make me feel like I have a reason for still being in Arcadia Bay.
Except not dead.
I hope so.
Stop being so goddamn humble. You're like the smartest, most talented person I've ever known.
More than Rachel Amber?
Dude, I'm not her groupie, okay? And I'm sure you have Blackwell bros all over you. Like Warren.
Get off my... yeah, he's nice.
Warren is nice.
He's trying hard.
Nice? Ouch. That means friend zone.
No, he's really cool. It was so sweet when he stood up to Nathan.
You mean got his ass beat in by Nathan when he got sucker punched? Power.
No worries. Once you get over yourself, you're gonna make the world bow.
As long as you're there with me.
Don't look so sad. I'm never leaving you.
You know, some people enjoy being nothing special. Even if they are given the ability to be special,
because we're yapping instead of attacking each
other, they don't want to stand out.
I think I've had my pool experience for the year. Let's check.
Let's call it a draw.
I'm gonna freeze my ass off when I get out.
Not much freeze. We had the obligatory sexy pool scene with the ladies. Now back to your regular scheduled program.
Gross. I feel like we just went swimming in Chlorine Bay.
Yeah, it literally is Chlorine Bay.
Thanks.
That's why they have showers, to get all that. Oh.
Hide.
Hey, is it David Madsen? Step prick. All right, let's just move here and get moving. Gotta go. No.
We have to go now.
Diddy Mao. Got to go now.
Are you shitting me?
How many security guards do we have at this fucking school? You were... How did you... But... All right.
Dude, hide.
It's what like his fucking time powers, too.
I can use my power. Or just look for a hiding spot. Or both.
Okay, I couldn't find a hiding spot last time. So... Oh, no. Hello? That's... He's gonna come around that corner. We're gonna go for the hiding spot route. See if we can manipulate him, because it's actually giving me quite a third-person camera here. So we're gonna do a little bit juke and jiving, and then when I fuck that up...
Hello? Anybody there?
Well, where's Chloe? Chloe...
Better not try any Halloween pranks after today. I'm serious. I heard something over here.
Did you now? Fascinating.
Who's here? I got a flashlight and a stick.
Do you now?
Hey.
Oh, fuck. Uh-huh. Do I have to wait for him to fucking wander all the way along? That's bullshit. Can I fast forward at some point to not have to wait for that? Or, well, can I actually... I'm going to see how this turns out. Trying to juke and jive him. Go through the men's room and all that. Very interested to see how that turns out. Although I did shit the bed there.
Anybody there?